Alright, what's up guys? Johnny B here, and I got a little bad news for you guys. This is going to be my last video. At least for a while. I need to take a brief hiatus. So you won't see any videos. This is the last video I'm putting up. Just because I have finals next week, and I need to put my focus on that. So, I need to walk away from YouTube for a little bit. So I thought I should at least let you guys know that that I'm gonna step away from YouTube for a little bit, so you're not freaking out like, oh my god, there's no videos, oh my god, what's going on? I'm pretty good at putting up videos on the weekend, so at least I give you guys a heads up, so you're not freaking out like, there are no videos, what's going on? Ah! that's what I want to say. Rest of this video, if you remember, I did a video with, where I pimped out three videos from three big name commentators. And they said stuff in there that I kind of talked about, like my feelings about it, and I kind of want to continue it. So I think it's a nice way for me to make commentaries and show you guys other videos that you don't have to look and constantly wait for videos that you should check out. And I think I'll try and find like the best videos that I can and videos that I like to watch and that are not only entertaining but they have good points. And I'll give my own opinions on it. So that's what I'm gonna do. It can be big name or small name, doesn't matter. If you guys want to send me a video, if you think it's good enough, message me and I'll check it out and I'll watch it. I'll see what I can do. So I got two guys for you. First off, being Uncle Respawn. If you watch Machinima Respawn, you know what I'm talking about. The one and only Hutch. First thing he did with his video is he talked about he was sorry for not being a team player because he was killing too much in his previous videos. So it's not, to me, that's nice to see that he doesn't just care about getting kills. He cares about winning. He cares about the objective, which is nice. And that's the way I feel about the game. You gotta play the objective. You don't. I don't know. I don't like you. No, I'm just kidding. What he talked about in there was Ghost being overrated, and I agree a little bit and agree. And I somewhat disagree. Now, what he talked about with that is because the secondaries aren't that great. Ballistic knife, crossbow, not really easy. Not something you can really use very easily. What is it? The pistols are not as good as they used to be. They're not like Call of Duty 4. So what he does is he throws on the Strela missile, a launcher or whatever it is, and just shoots things down. Now, I actually agree with that. That's actually a really good idea. Because if you want to free up that first perk and you don't want to worry about air support, but you want to use something like a lightweight or scavenger or a flak jacket, throw on the Strela missile. The launchers are probably the best secondaries in the game so far, at least the way Hutch put it and just the way things are. I think they are the best secondaries to use. So that's my I feel like it's actually a really good idea if you want to use it. But the fact that he calls it Ghost overrated, I finally got Ghost Pro, and actually I do like it. Now the reason I do like it is, if I throw it out with Marathon, what I can do is, as you guys know, I like playing the objective, and with the domination, I need to be moving, I need to be mobile. Now if I have a Strela missile and I'm using like something like lightweight, and I'm choosing to shoot things down, it kind of slows me down. I have to stop, find out where this thing is, and shoot it down. Now with Ghost Pro, if you can get a team that all uses Ghost Pro and you got a good team, and you don't have to worry about air support, except maybe the Blackbird, what you do is you don't have to worry about that. You guys can just focus on the objective. And that's what I think Ghost, I think, is the best. Ghost Pro, at least for me, is I don't have to worry about chopper gunners. I don't have to worry about air support. I can just continually my focus on the objective and make sure we keep those two flags, and I don't have to worry about it too much. So that's just the way I think it's going to be. For me, that's the reason I use Ghost, honestly. So I've got one other guy for you to talk about, and this is Tetra Ninja. And oh, actually, real quickly, if you go watch Hutch's video, he shows you secret spots in a summit. If you've never seen these spots or if you've seen people in there, will show you how to get there. Now, the guy's Tetra Ninja. I found this guy through Bill Keys a while ago. And I'm actually going to be keeping eyes on him. He's actually really a commentator, really good. Yeah, I think he should be really in the upper echelon of YouTube commentators out there. He talked about pub stomping. And pretty much he was saying that seeing insane KDs aren't really the best things to watch. Unless it's maybe 100 plus kills, that might not be very enticing, especially if you're just in with a party. Because most players on YouTube are at least above average. I would say I'm slightly above average. So putting above average players against just randoms, it's just, you guys will just destroy. So I like seeing 100 plus if the guy is possibly rushing. If I see 100 plus or something like big crazy KD, I'll click at it. I'll click it. I'll check it out. I'll see if it's entertaining gameplay. I'll continue to watch it. If not, I don't know. But and he talked about like YouTube, all the commentators getting together and getting these crazy games. And I kind of disagree a little bit. Now, first off, the KD, I agree with the KD thing. Just because you have a ridiculous KD doesn't mean it's really that great gameplay. I try to give you the gameplays you've seen where I got like really good KDs. Some have been rushing, like this one. This is 25. Nah, this is not bad. For the most part, I'm running around. Some of the other ones, maybe not so. But I try and play a tactical way, showing you guys that that I can get kills. I'm doing it in a more skilled way than anything. And then playing with party, I kind of disagree a little bit, because at times when you're playing with randoms, if you're like me and you get those randoms that don't play the objective and can't kill Horde, it gets very frustrating. It becomes very tough, and I'm just like, I can't take it. Playing with party, sometimes some of the other guys might have big games and you might get a good game. Playing with party, I think it's just, I enjoy it more. I just have more fun that way. It's people I can trust when I play with them. So that was my two cents on everything. See you guys all later.